I'm Lisa from Mythical Witchery. Welcome to my channel, and if you've been here before, welcome back. Today I am doing an unboxing and a flip through of the limited edition of the This Might Hurt Tarot and This Might Help Oracle. I know I'm really late coming to the party, but I just received this and I'm so excited. So let's have a look. Jellybean is already here checking things out. Okay, so just a little bit about this deck. This is a really special deck for me. Although I'm not personally part of the LGBTQ community, I have family members and dear friends who I love deeply who are. So supporting this community is really important to me. This is a hand-drawn deck, and it was originally an indie deck by American artist Isabella Rotman with coloring by Addison Duke. Isabella released this on Kickstarter in 2019, and it was fully funded in less than a day. It had 6 print runs before being published as a limited edition in April of 2023 by Liminal 11 in the UK. This limited edition is currently priced at £80 on their website. It includes a bonus oracle deck called This Might Help, which is 34 cards. The deck itself is 79, so includes all the normal cards plus one extra card. So this mass market edition is also available on Amazon, just the deck itself for, I believe it's on Amazon.com, it's between $20 and $25 US, and Amazon.co.uk for about £26. So the deck, as described by the creator, she says, This Might Hurt Tarot is a modern deck in the Rider-Waite-Smith tradition, keeping time-honored symbolism and imagery, but losing the medieval context. This deck is designed to be both easy to read and highly relatable. Clothing and scenery are modernized, diversity is embraced, and queerness is lovingly acknowledged. So, let's open this up. This was the box that it arrived in. And I have cut it open. And here it is. Jellybean just knocked something over back there. All right. So I'll just put this big box down on the floor and he will for sure go and check that out. He loves a box. I don't know any cats that don't. Okay, so here it is, all nicely packaged in here, and I need to get a knife to cut this open, so I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So I have taken the plastic off this. We'll just have a look at this box. What a beautiful box. Just love this. Swords, cups, got the Ouroboros. Oh, that's just a beautiful, beautiful box. So here we go. So I don't know if you can see that there. This is it. What a gorgeous box this is. This is designed to be a keepsake box. Love the little dog. And then there is a certificate of authenticity. They did a limited print run of 2,000 copies. This one is numbered 1,554 of 2,000. Also comes with this lovely reading cloth. And there seems to be some kind of a cotton material. So it's not like satiny or silk or anything slippery like that, but just look at this. You see that? The way that's been printed on there. And that is a beautiful big cloth. I know you can't see just how big this is, but yeah, that's gorgeous. Really gorgeous. Okay. Put this aside. Then we've got, this is a pocket tarot journal. Says reading the tarot is a self-reflective work. With every card we draw, we pull back the veil and gaze inward. I encourage you to record your readings and your thoughts and feelings about them in this book. Let the introspective spirit of the High Priestess guide you. The magic is in the interpretation and what you do with it. And then each page or a couple of pages, you can date it, put your question, draw your spread, and your interpretation. So that's a nice, handy little book. Easy to take with you if you're traveling. Really like that. Okay, so here we go. This is velvet. Wow, it looks so beautiful. So it's got the thumb holes here, so it's easy to take the decks out. I decided to go with the limited edition rather than the one from Amazon because I really wanted this Oracle deck. And I don't believe you can buy this separately. So that's the inside. Oh, this comes out. So if you want to use this box to store other things, that's a good box too. It's really high quality, so it would be perfect for storing things or keep the velvet thing in here. And keep your decks in there if you like. That really looks beautiful. It would look nice on a shelf too, I think. Really pretty. Most things in life worth doing might hurt. How true is that? Okay. So we've got two decks here. We've got the This Might Hurt Tarot and This Might Help Oracle deck. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through this deck first and then this one. If you want to skip ahead, there will be timestamps in the description box. So feel free to skip ahead to any section that you like. After I go through this deck, I will give it a shuffle. And I'll do the same thing with this and we'll also have a look at the guidebooks. So I'll put this aside for now and we'll look at this. So it comes in this lovely box. And it opens up. Oh, see how that opens up there. So it's a magnetic closure. It's got a little thumb thing on each side. Make it easy. Look at that design there. And then this slides out. Oh wow. That's the inside. And then the cards are in here. So I like that. I really like that design. Because they just fit securely in there. That's a really unique design, isn't it? But unlike some that open at the bottom, the cards won't just fall out because they actually have this little thing to keep them. And we've got some of the cards on there. And here's the cards themselves. Looks like it's got a couple of pieces of cardboard there just to, probably just to protect it. So I would just take those out. Guidebook in here and the cards. I'll put those aside for the moment and we'll look at the guidebook. I'll just put this back in here. Okay, so this is the guidebook. So it's in color. She's got the introduction on gender and tarot. We'll have a look at that. Card descriptions, how to read tarot, some spreads. And then the introduction. She says, when I first started drawing This Might Hurt tarot in 2015, I was creating a deck that accurately and adoringly reflects my world. My world is complicated and rich. It is queer and diverse. There are disabled people, fat people, brown people, black people, gay people, trans people, people who dye their hair and ride scooters and have big thighs and are covered in tattoos. Many of these cards are portraits of my friends and my family. This deck is more to me than a modern reimagining of Arthur Waite and Pamela Smith's historic deck. It is a loving portrait of the rich tapestry of my life. The phrase, this might hurt, is something that I've been using for my work for a while, long before I started drawing the tarot deck. I draw comics that are surreal, dreamlike exercises in trying to understand and heal from issues in my personal life. And then she just continues why she created the deck. This section here on gender and tarot. She says, tarot tradition is saturated in gender. It's inescapable. As someone who strives to create art that people of all genders can connect with, I found the prominence of binary gender within tarot difficult to reckon with. Traditional tarot decks have a definitive idea of which traits are feminine and which traits are masculine. For example, the Empress represents the softer side of the feminine archetype. She is gentle, motherly, and tied to nature. She has a sensual sexuality. She's pure emotion. The High Priestess represents the darker aspects of the divine feminine archetype. She's hidden and patient. She's intuitive and otherworldly. She is a mystery. Together, the traits of the Empress and the High Priestess represent tarot's idea of the feminine, a collection of women's qualities as assigned by men. And she talks about the Emperor and the Magician, how the feminine and masculine traits can be found throughout the tarot with kings and queens and so on. And she says, I'm not going to read the whole thing to you, but I just want to point out a few of the high points here. She says, tarot wants us to be in balance, and gender is one of the symbolic elements it uses to talk about that. So when reading this book and using this deck, please keep the following in mind. When I say masculine or feminine, I mean a set of traits that have been assigned as masculine or feminine in the tradition of tarot. When I say man or woman, I'm referring to the gender of the character in the card. I am not referring to their biological sex as determined by genitalia. Do not assume, because a character has a clearly defined gender, that they are cis. In this deck, gender is fluid. If gender matters symbolically to the meaning of the card, I have retained the gender expressed in the Rider-Waite-Smith deck. If gender doesn't matter, I may have changed it or removed any gender cues. Okay. And then we've got the Major Arcana cards. So you get the full page color image, which is super, and a full description of the cards. We'll just skip back to the Minor Arcana here. So she talks about the numbers, aces, twos, threes, and so on. The different suits, gives an overview, and the court cards. And then a good description of each one of the cards as well. So that is an absolutely fantastic guidebook. Let's see if about spreads here. Talks about reverse meanings. So three card spreads, cycle of healing, which is six cards, path to the world. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in a minute. Not quite yet. First, we'll talk about the cards. So I'll just take them out of this little plastic bit. And these are backs. They are a glossy stock. And they've got this beautiful silver holographic edging. And you know, it feels It feels really nice. It's fairly smooth. I don't think that this would hurt my fingers at all. Hello again. Hello, Jelly Bean. Okay. As far as card sizes, I'm assuming that these are pretty standard, but let's have a look here. So we have 70 millimeters, so that would be 2.75 inches by 120, which would be 4.7 inches. So a standard tarot size. The cards are, they're quite flexible. I'm not sure what the grams per square inch are, but they feel, I don't know, kind of mid-range to me. So now I will zoom in and we'll have a closer look at these cards. All right, so starting with the Fool. I love this. I love the modern impressions here. Although we've got the mountains in the distance, which are very traditional, we've also got a city here and a bridge. Yeah, very, very modern feel. The Magician. All the traditional symbols and tools. Okay, those are slightly stuck together, so I may have to actually let me just gently. And that should separate most of them. Okay, I just noticed that I've got a reflection here, so let me just move my light a bit so we don't have a reflection directly on the card. Okay, High Priestess. I love her. Oh, she's beautiful. I love the little mushrooms. Beautiful. The Empress. Oh, my. Stunning. I love the little heart that's been etched into the tree trunk there, and how the symbol of Venus is inside of it, and all the stars on her head. Beautiful. The Emperor. Again, a very modern interpretation. The Hierophant. The Lovers. Oh, what a beautiful card. The Chariot. I love this. Love this. I have not seen any full walkthroughs of this deck before today. But I've heard so many things about it. And I've seen a few cards here and there. Like I've seen this card. And of course that's on the cover of the deck as well. So this is a whole new experience for me. Oh my. Oh, I love this. The Hermit is my card. That's my personal card. And so it's one of the cards in the deck that I look for to see if I resonate with that card. You know, because it matters. If your personal card isn't something that you really love, it might be a bit more challenging to really resonate with the deck. But that's beautiful. A Wheel of Fortune. Love to hear what you think. Justice. Oh, Jelly Beans on one. The Hanged Man. The only thing that really surprises me about this is that a choice wasn't made to go with the Hanged One, for example, instead of the Hanged Man, but that's not a criticism, just a surprise. That's not what I would have expected. Death. This little girl here holding up a flower. Beautiful. Temperance. Hot and cold. Mixing cold into hot. Perfect balance. Sorry, these cards are still a little bit stuck together. The Devil. Them all down here just drinking and partying and carousing and engaging in all kinds of behavior that may not be the healthiest. The Tower. The Star. It looks like she's holding North American style. No, sorry. British style milk jugs. I don't know why I said North American style. Or maybe things have changed in the 10 years that I've lived over here in the UK, but looks like milk jugs. Sorry for getting a bit off topic here. The Moon. I love that there's hair on the legs here, and you can't really tell gender. But I love the hairy legs. The Sun. I love that the baby is riding, it looks like a poodle. What do they call them? Giant poodles. Judgment. Loving Anubis here. Weighing a heart and a feather. The World. This is another one of the cards that I have seen. I love this. I really love this. You don't often see this much body diversity in a deck. So it's lovely to have a deck of cards that I can see myself in. And moving into the Wands. And the Two. Oh, I love that. Sitting on the car and old style station wagon planning a journey. This deck, everything I'd heard about it, I really sort of saw this deck as being a queer deck, an LGBTQ deck. But it's more than that. It's more than that. It's just a diverse deck. We've got body diversity, we've got ability. I'm assuming based on the what was said in the guidebook, Three of Wands. because Isabella said something about disability as well, and being a disabled person myself, you don't see a lot of that in tarot decks. See the odd bit more and more these days, often as the Chariot, which is a bit stereotypical, but I just love the bunnies here. Sorry, I feel like a real chatty Cathy today. Five of Wands. Sometimes when I do a flip through, I'm really quiet and usually just really absorbed by the cards. Six of Wands. And then other times I get really chatty. To my apologies, you can always mute me if you like. I won't mind. Seven of Wands. Love the bow, the compound bow. I used to have a compound bow back when I was more able-bodied. Eight of Wands. I love that we have movement in this card, not just of the arrows, but the animals moving. They're all running at speed. I love that, seeing something other than just eight wands moving quickly. Nine. Loving all the different pens and pencils there. And the 10. That is quite a burden. That little bird on top. Page of Wands. I love this deck. Oh my gosh, I really, really love this. Knight of Wands. I think I might use this for next week's Cards in a Cuppa. I love that he's on a motorcycle. They are on a motorcycle. Queen of Wands. King. And moving into the Cups. That's a beautiful card. Two of Cups. I love this. Love this. I love that they're holding coffee cups too. Oh, that's fantastic. Three of Cups. Oh, beautiful. I love the fact that they're all so different from each other. You get that sense that they're the best of friends. Lovely. Four of Cups. I love that she's meditating. I couldn't possibly tell you the pose. I'm not a yoga pro, but I know she's meditating. I know that much. Five of Cups. This is another one of those cards that I look carefully at in a deck when I'm making a decision to buy a deck. Really love this. They really are still sticking together. Well, they won't be by the time I'm finished. Six of Cups. You're probably getting sick and tired of hearing me saying, I love this. I love this card. I do. That's the seven. Love the look on her face here. Eight of Cups. Nine. Let me just there we go. Ten of Cups. Those were well stuck. Oh, that's beautiful. Gosh, I love that. Page. Another gorgeous page. Wow. I love the fish in the bag. Knight of Cups. And that's another knight riding a motorcycle. Brilliant. I wonder if all the knights are going to be riding motorcycles. Guess we'll find out. Queen of Cups. King of Cups. Oh, and here we've got some age diversity. That's lovely. Moving into the swords. Two of Swords. I just want to take a quick look here. So the wands all had this sort of orange, pinky orange in the cards. The cups, of course, have the blue throughout. Well, this one doesn't, but they're still blue. Well, it looks like blues and purples. Swords. I'm assuming we'll have the sort of green, greeny, yellow. Three of Swords. Well, let me just separate those. Four of Swords. Five of Swords. Six. Little snake in the water here. Seven of Swords. Eight. Separate those again. Nine of Swords. That was really good. Nine of Swords. Ten of Swords. Wow. Yeah, that's beautiful. Beautiful card. Page of Swords. night. And yes, another motorcycle. Queen of Swords. I love the glasses. They're so cute. King of Swords. Loving that we've got a wheelchair here for the king. And moving into the Pentacles. The two. You get that sense, don't you, that she's really trying to balance things. Three of Pentacles. Four. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine of Pentacles. Oh, such a beautiful card. Ten. There are so many cards in this deck that are just, they're all stunning. They're beautiful. I love this deck. Page. Knight. I love that this is showing farmland here. Queen. Looks like this queen is on a scooter. Mobility scooter. King of Pentacles. And it looks like the extra card. So this is the this might hurt, this might help card. So this might hurt, and this might help. Okay, I think I'm going to shuffle both cards at the end because I can move the camera up to do that. So I'm just going to put these aside for now and we'll have a look at the Oracle deck. Just get these out of the way so they're not in the camera and distracting. So this is the box. And again, we've got this bottom style opening here. Take out the little piece that and then it has the little instruction book. And this is all just in black and white, but gives full descriptions of each of the cards. So, the Oracle deck, these are the backs, and these don't have any edging on them, and they are smaller. So this is the tarot, and these are the Oracle cards. So they're about the same width, but they're not as long. And they are glossy, and they've got, they're sort of, I don't know if this is called embossing, I'm not sure if you can see that, but the blue on there is quite shiny, and it's embossed, so you can actually feel that. That was the dog, and we've got the Magician's Wand. Well, that's interesting, because the dog is the first card, and that's numbered 0. And of course, we see the dog and the fool. And then the Magician's Wand. So that relates to the magician. The veil, which relates to the high priestess. The 12-star crown. The empress. The ram. Of course, the emperor. The 5 crossed keys. So that represents the Hierophant. The bow of arrows. So of course the lovers. The steed. The chariot. This is great. I love this. The garland. With strength. The lantern. The hermit. So I get these little fluffs and they really bug me. The snake. The battered sword. The rope. Of course, to represent the hanged man. The banner of death. The middle path. So this represents temperance. Shackles, the devil. I'm just going to have a peek in the introduction here to the guidebook. The lightning bolt, so that's the tower. So in the guidebook, she says each card depicts an archetype or universal human experience, and within that, every single card can be boiled down to a good piece of advice. Interpreting these universal concepts into your individual experience through the process of reading. Now that is magic. That is what art is about. Ibises. So of course that was the star. The mask. Representing the moon, the sunflower, of course, for the sun, the feather of truth for judgment, Ouroboros for the world. I'm interested to see what's coming next. Okay, we've got water. The hot drink. The broken cup. Bird in flight. Now we've moved into air. The blindfold. The double-edged sword. I'm moving into the fire cards with the bonfire. The cat. Oh, I love it. Love it. The salamander. And the earth cards, the fertile earth. The hooded falcon. And the coins. Okay, so I'm going to zoom this out a little bit. We'll take a look at the shuffle, and then we'll take a look at something from the guidebook. Okay, so I've broken my finger, so shuffling these days is pretty difficult for me. But let's just see how these fan, if they fan out. They seem to stick together a little bit, so I wouldn't say that's the best fan in the world, but I mean, it's whatever. Now for the shuffle. This is a test. They're a little stiff. They almost seem like they would be prone to bowing eventually. That's why I often will turn the cards this way and sort of mix it up so that it kind of corrects it so the bow doesn't end up happening. Of course, if you could fully riffle shuffle, you probably wouldn't get that. But you can actually see how this already has just a slight bow in it, and that's the very first time that I've shuffled. So I hope it wouldn't get too bad, but yeah, standing them up, I don't know if you can. I can see it more standing them up than I can when they're laying flat, but they've got just a little bit of a curve to them. But anyway, your mileage is going to vary with shuffling because you probably don't have a broken finger. So. And with my arthritis, I struggle to shuffle at the best of times. So these ones, again, they're very, very stiff cards. Probably they would be better to overhand than to riffle shuffle. Possibly the same with these. It's really hard to do that with this finger. Okay, so let's just have a look at one entry in the guidebook here. So the salamander, and this is a, hello jelly bean, out of the way. Okay, so the salamander, the ability to withstand fire. From the ancient Romans to the Renaissance, it was a common belief that salamanders were fire elementals who could survive or extinguish flames. These legends most likely developed because salamanders often shelter in rotting logs. Throw an old wet log on a fire and a salamander may just crawl out to escape the flames, leading to the belief that salamanders sprang from the fire itself. What is a legend about the ability to endure fire, if not a metaphor for resilience? Resilience is the ability to withstand and adapt to difficult and challenging life experiences. Being resilient does not mean experiencing less distress, grief, and pain than other people. It means using coping methods and mindsets to handle adversity in ways that foster healing and growth. As a clarifier, the salamander will land on a card when you need to harness your capacity for resilience. There will be fires, but you can survive them. So that is lovely. So, you know, based on this, I really do like this little oracle deck. And I'm very glad that I paid the extra money to, in order to get the limited edition, which included the oracle deck. All right. So my final thoughts on these cards, on this deck. I love this deck. I love the colors. I love the art style. I think it's fun. I love, love, love the diversity, the inclusivity. There's nothing about this deck that I don't like. Other than, it's not my ideal cardstock. You know, my ideal cardstock is very flexible, preferably linen, something easy to shuffle. These are not easy to shuffle, and certainly not easy to shuffle with a broken finger. But, you know, my finger's not going to be broken forever. And there's always a way. So I wouldn't not use this deck just because of difficulty in shuffling it. In fact, I love this deck enough that, and having said that, there are decks that I have put aside because I found them too difficult to shuffle. But I don't think this would be one of them. I would definitely use this deck. So, what do you think? What do you think? Love to hear your thoughts, your opinions. Pop them in the comments below the video. I'd love to hear what you think of the deck. Do you have this deck? If you do, have you been using it for a while? I know it has been out for quite a few years now. And having used it for a while, what do you think of it? If you have never used this before, but you've been thinking about getting it, what do you think after watching this flip through? I mean, there's a lot of flip throughs out there. Mine is not the only one by a long stretch. There are many, many flip throughs. But anyway, I love this deck. I love it. I think it's a wonderful deck. An incredible addition to the world of tarot. And it's, I'm very impressed. Very impressed. Okay, thank you so much for watching me today. I really appreciate your support of my channel. Give it a like if you found it useful. Subscribe if you haven't already. And hit the notification bell if you'd like to be notified of future videos. Have a wonderful day. Until next time, may love and laughter light your days. Bye for now.